really tell the story of Thistle Farms, you have to begin at the beginning. Becca Stevens grew up in Nashville, running barefoot through that crabgrass and clover, bright and restless and always questioning. Questions like, who decided that some plants are flowers and others are weeds? Thankfully, Becca never stopped asking why.
When we decided on the name Thistle Farms, it made perfect sense. I mean, thistles were the only flower still growing in the alleys and in the streets. And while they have this prickly outer exterior that makes them a noxious weed, they also have a deep, soft purple center. And all of us have both of those parts in us.
Wow, I'm sitting here and we're about to celebrate 20 years at Thistle Farms / Magdalene. Can't leave Magdalene out. Oh my goodness, it is like, what a journey, what a blessing, what a gift that's been given, not just to me, but so many other women.
I remember thinking about the idea as being a great idea, but very difficult to make work in practice. That was when I thought of Becca as a community volunteer rather than a force of nature, which I later learned was the actual case.
The energy was always, it felt like we were on kind of a grand adventure. And we really weren't clear where we were going to end up, but we were all in it together.
Here's the thing, we were doing residential work with the women for 4 years before we ever started Thistle Farms. The women were coming, they were doing great work. They were making restitution with the courts and with their family. They were working on addiction issues. They're going to the rape and sexual assault center to get help with trauma and recovery. But they were still dirt poor, and we thought, we have to start our own company. It made sense that it was a company that was not just gonna be, you know, for women's healing, but run by women for healing.
You know, I walked a 10-block radius for well over 20 years, and I could not find a way out. And I was just trapped. I had lost all hope.
It was very difficult to get a job because of my police background. And they hired me. They let me work the register and be accountable for money. They let me go to the bank. But they allow me the opportunity to develop job skills.
In 2014, we saw our sales hit the $1 million mark, but more importantly, our women were staying clean and sober, gaining more viable job skills.
Thistle Farms is just beginning to hit its stride. We are growing and we are thriving because so many people have joined us in this circle of hope. They have taken a story that has been horrific and turned it into a story of great hope and inspiration to remind us that we don't have to leave anybody behind on this journey, that women recover and women can be powerful testimonies to the truth that love is the most powerful force in the world.